sledgehammer. The gator's jaw slammed down on his shoulder.
Nigga wanna see me fall. Stephen Curry, how I ball. Gosha garments and a white three on my body. I'm an icon, man. And my girl about a 10. I should fuck her in the Benz. Nigga city run my hometown. I don't know how I'm a prince in it, man. All we talk about is checks.
Cash, rack, bills, meth, stacks.
Yeah, what it do, people? It's your boy Ken over here at Katie Kennel. We are back again here to do a 2-week puppy update on the 10K and Diva Lair. Possum at 2 weeks old yesterday, yeah, or day before yesterday. So just here give you guys 2-week update and hey guys, see what the pups are looking like. Crap. Hey guys, sorry about that. So, without further ado, let's jump in it. Last time I start with the chocolate ones. This time I'm gonna start with the Merle. I'm gonna start with the Merle males. And there we go. It's a little blue Merle. Let's see. Nice and clean. Look at that boy. Thick. These are gonna be some nice ones. This one is a male and it is a blue Merle. People looking good. This is male number 2. He's also a bloomer, but it seems like, well, not seems like, he's actually a trimer, right? He's a blue, yeah. But he's also a tri as well. And this is male number 2. Tri markings on him is kind of dull, as you guys can see. Just like his mom, because Diva tri markings actually dull. Not as bright as they would be on 10K. But yeah. And look at this guy. Nice and clean. This is the second male. And this is third male. As you guys know, we only have 3 males in this litter. Look at this boy here. Well, I'm gonna go with what everybody say. He's a lilac with chocolate Merle markings. Come on, can I get it with me? Yeah. Look at this boy. Beast, man. Real chunky. Yep. Yeah, guys. As you know, today in the Caribbean, place kind of real hot. Approaching summertime, so yeah, we'll get that hot rain in it. This is the third and final male. That's the a lilac Merle with chocolate markings. And those are the 3 males that we have. That one, I'm gonna keep this chocolate male. I'm gonna keep that one. So now I'll let you guys see the females. This is everybody favorite. Everybody seems to love this girl. Right? And for some reason, I had already decided I wasn't going to keep her. Right? But unless I get the right price, yeah, she'll be staying. But if somebody made me an offer, a good, decent offer, not just any offer, yeah, she's up for grabs. As you guys can see, she's nice. And she clean, man. Whoa. Looking at that, dude. Look at that. And guys, I'm still trying to figure out which one of these pups is the runt. Still can't find a runt. And this is the second Merle female. This is a lilac Merle, a lilac tri-merle actually. That was also, well, I call that one a chocolate tri-merle. This one is the only one that come out looking like mom, but as you can see, that daddy headpiece. So yes, this girl is gonna be real, real awesome. This is gonna make somebody kennel. Going up in stock, man. Anybody grab this girl instantly, your kennel gone up in stock without a doubt. And she is feisty. This girl is.
Mama, relax. I'm giving you nothing. You good?
Of course. Yeah, people. So, pups are at 2 weeks now. And yeah, we're just giving you guys an update, let you guys see, you know, how they're progressing. These guys are doing well. Diva is an excellent mother. Like, real, 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 real good. Right? Couldn't ask for a better mother. Saskia is probably the only dog I ever had, which is a better mother than she. Because Saskia, she territorial dog. No, I was the only person can touch Saskia puppies them. And Diva, well, she allowed my wife to touch them, but yeah. So yes, people, that is the second female and the second Merle female. The rest of females them are chocolate tries. So here we go. Look at this little one here. Short and thick. Just got this little girl here have a little white patch on the nose, come right down to mouth under bottom jaw. Also she have the white patch in the back of her neck. Yeah. Yeah, people, pups them looking real nice. That's one thing I can see. Well, yeah, this litter here, yeah, did what he's supposed to do. And this is the fourth female. Man, she's thick. She is huge. She probably the one, I might say, yeah, probably have a little more size than the rest of them. Or maybe she have a sister where, you know, up there with she. But as you guys can see, these guys are chunky. 2 weeks old, and look at the, you know, look at the size on them already. Yeah. Little sleepy head. He just dropping asleep. Them stomach full, so yeah. What am I going to do? Nothing but sleep. So yeah, people, here you have it. This is the fourth female, and she is a chocolate tri. Now this will be the fifth and final female, also a chocolate tri. Look at the melon on this girl. Yep, people. She looking real nice. And as you can see, guys, the eye is open already. Doesn't seem like they can see us yet, but the eye is open. Just a couple days ago, some of them start posturing up and, you know, walking around and things like that already. These pups are really, really, really strong. Maybe some of the strongest pups them that ever born on the Katy Kennel yard, because these guys are already crawling out the whelping box already, right? And it is a foot high, right? 12 inch high, and they're already crawling out of it. They're already climbing up on the one end of the box, hanging on and jumping over. Actually two of them crawled out yesterday morning, because the mother actually lay down in the front of the box instead inside it, and they wanted to get to her, so they did the thing and they get out. Yeah, baby, get it out. Yep. So yeah, people, these are the pups them, all eight of the pups them, doing real, real good, right? We still have a few pups available. So which pup is available? This girl, this lilac trimeral, this girl is available. You guys know how to reach me. The link will be in the description, my number as well, so you guys can hit me up, shoot me a message, Facebook, Instagram, you know. So yeah, serious inquiry only, right? You don't want nobody messaging me and asking me a bunch of foolish questions just to hack safe. All right, we're dealing with serious people only. People, if you don't have at least 5,000 US, all right, at least 5,000 US, don't even bother to message me and ask me the price or anything like that. I'm telling you guys now, research your dog first before you go asking buyer, seller or breeders how much is your dog, just to ask sake, right? Just research the dog so you have an idea of what these dog costs, right? Or what the bottom price is where you're looking at to get one of these dogs. All right, I got a bunch of people calling me, messaging me, all sort of hoes, just the hawks. How much is the puppy? You understand? Come on, guys, these are American Bully, these are Merle and Chocolate Tries. You should do your research, know at least, yeah, this price, this dog might be up in this price range, right? So you have an idea. Don't call me asking me a bunch of foolish questions and then, you know, you ain't buying it. One guy tell me he could build a house with the money that I'm asking for the puppy. Okay, so go build a house. You understand? This is what we buy them for. This is what we sell them for. You understand? People think breeding is just, oh, put food around or put on food and dog have puppies. There's a lot of time and effort goes into this. All right? Most of you guys I'm out there where want buy a pup and come crying down your price. You guys ain't doing what we're doing. Alright? You see how much dogs I have? You see how much dogs I have? Every single load of poop where they drop, I gotta clean that up by myself. I don't have any stuff. Alright? It's me and my wife. Alright? We gotta feed them. We gotta take care of them. Vet. Everything. Right? So, unless you guys know about breeding, don't judge me based on the price. Oh, the price too high. Price too high for you. If these prices are too high, that means these dogs are not for you. All right? So, guys, stray off topic a little bit, but then we'll get back to it. Yeah. Pup which is available. This girl is available as well. Yep. This girl is available. Nice addition to anybody can help. Also, this boy. Come here, boy. Oh, it's this one. Yeah. This one is available. Yep. These are the pups that I have available. Most of the pups, as I said, already gone. you know, the few that we have available. Honestly, I don't mind keeping them. So if I'm not getting the right price, I'm not selling them. All right, I'm not giving these away. All right, we work real hard on this. Yeah, I think they're more than worth what we're asking for, to be honest. Actually, we are asking under the going rate for one of these dogs. All right, you guys can check around and see if my price is not the best out there, and you're getting high quality puppy. So yes, guys, there you have it. Those are the 8 pups from the 10K and Diva Lair. Guys, don't forget, tell a friend, tune into the KD Kennel YouTube channel. Also, you guys can find us on Instagram, KD Kennel, TikTok, KD Kennel, or you guys can look me up on Facebook under KN Daily. So yeah, people, here you have it. This is what we're doing right now. Don't have any other breeding I doing on my yard at the moment. I actually have Saskia down there in heat. I have Harrier here in heat as well, but we're not doing any more breeding until these pups reach at least a certain age, right? And I don't really have any plans for, you know, do any immediate breeding right now. Right now we have some other dogs supposed to come in. We're working on something big. So until that happen, then we're going, you know, reevaluate and see how we move on from there. Yes, we have some breeding which we already plan to do, but until these pups reach a certain age, because I don't know about the rest of kennels I'm out there, but KD Kennel, we're not breeding for breeding's sake, right? We're not breeding just to make money. We're trying to make good quality dogs, you understand me? So yeah, that's what I'm about. That's what my thing is about. I want to make the best American Bully possible, right? Yes, guys, and as you can tell, I love colors, right? I love the dogs and with the colors, but also we want them with good quality structure, you understand me? I'm gonna start jumping in the show ring a little more often now, so I'm gonna put some more effort into the show program. So yeah, we will be going after the show quality dogs then, as we always do, but now we're gonna put out a little more effort in terms of that, in terms of that department. All right, there's a couple people that hit me up. Guys, if I haven't responded to your comment, or I haven't get back to you, like, since I post these dogs, it's like crazy messages and calls, right? And I just haven't had the time, because as I tell people, I have a construction business I run as well, right? I'm not just sitting home just mining dogs, right? I actually have a 9-to-5 where I do at the same time, right? So my apology, guys. If I take long to get back to you, I will get back to you. Maybe, you know, take a little while, but yeah, we'll reach out back to everybody. Because as I said, it's me and my wife, pretty much the social media part of it. Everything is done by me, right? So, you know, it take a while to get through to, because sometimes we post on different sites. So, you know, checking each site, you know, reaching out to everybody, people DM you, people in the comment section, you know, right across the board. So sometimes it does take a while, right? So we appreciate you guys' patience. We appreciate love, respect to all. Like I said, tell a friend, KD Kennel is where it's at. Check out the YouTube channel, Instagram, Facebook, TikTok, wherever you guys support us. Love and respect. As you see over KD Kennel. Yo, peace, much love.